Hi guys! So today I'm going to do book reviews for Julia Donaldson for little toddlers and kids that you have, and these are my 5-star, 4-star and meh reviews for all the Julia Donaldson books that I own. So let's start. So the first one, of course, is The Gruffalo, which I do not have because I think my daughter has taken it out and I don't know where it is. It's probably under some bedsheet or something. So the first book that I was introduced to from Julia Donaldson was The Gruffalo. I didn't like this is The Gruffalo, okay? This guy. So I did not like The Gruffalo at all. I thought he was not cute and not sweet or whatever. And then I read the book to my daughter and she absolutely loved him. So the Gruffalo book is very dog-eared and she knows the whole thing by heart and she loves it. That is a definitely 5-star read. I mean, Julia Donaldson hit something, you know, some nerve she hits in little kids' minds and hearts, that they immediately love that little, not very cute animal who's an amalgamation of everything that you could think of. And this is the second one, the sequel to that, which is The Gruffalo's Child. Again, The Gruffalo's Child is very cute. It's about the child of the Gruffalo who again is trying to follow the father's footsteps. And the illustrations are by Axel Scheffler. These are published by Macmillan. And again, I thought these illustrations are a little kiddish, but I think my daughter loves them and I have grown to love them as well. So I think these are definitely a 5-star read, and these are for older kids, one would say, but I have been reading them to my daughter since she was about 1.5 years old and she loves them. So give them a try. So The Gruffalo and The Gruffalo's Child, thumbs up. Okay. The next 5-star read is, of course, The Room on the Broom. Room on the Broom. That's a witch. So, okay, the witch concept is not very, now it is pretty prevalent in India with all those cartoons and stuff. But still, you know, the witch, this is like a friendly witch and she's got a ginger plait and a cat and this cauldron and a hat. And it's really, really sweet. It's about this story is about sharing and being kind to others, and you know, standing up, united we stand, divided we fall, wala thing. And again, Axel Scheffler illustrations, you can see they are very typical with those circular eyes and you know, sort of, there you go. So I think this is again a very, very sweet story, and it has a good message, and definitely another 5-star must have from Julia Donaldson. Okay, then the third favorite. Okay, these are not just my favorites. I am actually telling you these from my daughter's point of view also. If I keep all the books in front of her, these are the ones that she picks up first. So next, the third one, of course, is Cave Baby. This has illustrations by Emily Gravett, and look at that. It has gorgeous illustrations, completely different style from Axel Scheffler. And the story is about this cave baby who wants to draw, and his parents don't think that, you know, that is what he should be doing. He's wasting his time, kind of thing. And then a mammoth comes along and takes him, and it's really sweet. And I think it's about basically encouraging creativity in kids. Somebody told me that they didn't like Cave Baby because they thought it encouraged a kid to leave parents. But I didn't think of it that way, and I thought it was really sweet. And the thing about Julia Donaldson books are all the narrative is in a rhyming kind of like a poem. Not exactly a poem, but in a rhyme. So, you know, when you read it, it becomes very easy for the child to follow and then to, you know, pick up and then follow you and start speaking and getting the story. Of course, the illustrations are lovely, no doubt. And the fourth one is The Snail and the Whale. Again, Axel Scheffler illustrations. So this is about this tiny snail who hitches a ride with a whale, and goes around the world because he wants to see the world. And then one day the whale gets into trouble, and the tiny, tiny snail finds that he can do something to help her, even though he's not very sure in the beginning. So that again, nice message and great illustrations. Look at that. And definitely a great read. So that is there. These are all the 5-star illustrations that I had for Julia Donaldson. Now we come to the 4-star ones. So obviously this is the Go Away Bird. It is beautiful. It has just come out, I think, a few months back, and so I got it in hardcover. It's a bit expensive, but all right. The illustrations are to die for. They're by Catherine Raynard. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful illustrations. I just love these illustrations. So the story is about a bird who wants to be left alone until he gets into trouble, and then the other birds come to help him, and he realizes that he needs to be social. So, which is a good message again, but maybe I felt the rhyming and the sort of humor that was there in the other books, in the previous books, was just a tad bit missing in this, I think. But of course it's beautiful. The beauty of the artwork really, really compensates for whatever little bit I found lacking in the prose. But yes, the Go Away Bird is really sweet. A message for our times to be social, make friends, and help each other again. So that is there. Okay, then it is Zog and the Flying Doctors. Zog is the dragon and these are the Flying Doctors. So this is again a 4-star read because this is again for a slightly older kid, even though my daughter did pick up the message of the book, which was that girls don't just need to be princesses, don't just need to roam around in frilly frocks. They can be doctors too. They can be like, you know, they can do anything sort of. And which is a nice message, which surprisingly my daughter picked up, and I like that. So yes, but again, the illustrations by Axel Scheffler. And this particular edition is by Scholastic, Alison Green Books. So I don't know, I thought all Julia Donaldson books were Macmillan, but I don't know, this must be an older edition or something. So yes, along with the first, this is a sequel to the book called Zog. So I haven't read Zog. And there are quite a few other books with this. I think these are the older books before Gruffalo maybe. But so I haven't read those. But yes. So this is another 4-star read for kids. Then you have another one which is A Squash and a Squeeze. Julia Donaldson. Axel Scheffler again. Story about, you know, this is a very old story which most people know. I think from Aesop's Fables and from Panchatantra. About somebody living in a little house and then being unsatisfied until somebody, a religious person, tells them to get, you know, other people in the house and then chuck them out, and then she or he realizes that the house is big enough. The moral being, of course, that, you know, you should be happy with what you have. So that's again a sweet moral, a story that we all know, packaged in a new form for little kids. I think it's pretty nice. So yes, and then you have The Smartest Giant in Town, again Axel Scheffler, again about this huge giant who goes around helping people and you know, helping people, and then how people reciprocate by saying thank you and by loving him back. So this is about, you know, helping people who are in need, and nice ones. So these were 4-star reads. The other three that I have are just, they're just okay. So there's Hamilton's Hats. There's, as you can see, it's pretty new, and it's about this little piggy who has so many hats and, you know, keeps looking for them. But it's just all right. It's okay. Again, Axel Scheffler, and again by Macmillan. Then you have Charlie Cook's favorite book. It is about a book of Charlie Cook that Charlie Cook loves to read, and it has it links to other books, and it's basically I think to encourage reading. But I'm not really a fan. It didn't really have that strong a message, you know. It was almost as if it was done to just make up a book. I don't know. Some people really love it, but I didn't. So, meh. And then the very controversial Tyrannosaurus Drip. It's about this little dinosaur who's a vegetarian, gets adopted by mistake by these T-Rexes, and who are, of course, you know, non-vegetarians. And then one day, you know, he wants to go back and he's like, you are doing war and I don't like you. And then he goes back to his kind. And essentially at the end of the book, he kills his adopted family, like the parents and his sisters. I don't like that. I didn't like that at all. I was like, I didn't understand what the message about this was. I mean, I think she wanted to convey that it was about peace and harmony, but it didn't. It came across as being very, very ruthless, you know, like, especially about something such as, you know, being adopted, being different from your parents and stuff like that. The illustrations, of course, are beautiful. They are by David Roberts. So they're beautiful illustrations, but the story just, I was not very happy with them, not at all. So if you must buy only a few books of by Julia Donaldson, I would recommend, of course, The Gruffalo. Then you have The Gruffalo's Child, Room on the Broom, Cave Baby, of course. And I don't know, I just for the illustrations, The Go Away Bird, definitely for the illustrations, because they're so beautiful and so heartwarming. And yes, I think Julia Donaldson is a surprise for me to find that my daughter loved it, and we have spent many happy hours reading them, and hopefully she'll be coming up with some new books that we can add to our collection. So till next time, bye bye, see ya.